No, I remember a few years ago, I was at our cottage with my kids, and we drove the boat down the lake to visit some people at a nearby camp. By the time we left, it was pitch black. I hadn't thought of what it would be like to be on the water in the dark. You know, there weren't many cottages on our lake at the time, so everything, the shoreline was pitch black. I couldn't tell the difference between the water and the land. The sky was totally cloud-covered with no shining moon. It was frightening, to say the least. You know, at the time, I couldn't even find that flashlight that's supposed to be in every boat as a safety requirement, and I didn't think to leave a light on at my own cottage to guide me home. Oh, boy. So as I headed out on the water in total blackness, I strained to look ahead of me, and I suddenly saw this small light coming from a cottage way up on a hill not too far from our cottage. Well, that little light became my guide. I knew if I pointed the boat directly in line with it, I would avoid any shorelines, and I then could find my dock. What a relief when I pulled up to the dock without incident. That small light on that hill broke through all the darkness and showed us the way home. You know, this is who Jesus says he is. I am the light of the world. Jesus broke through the darkness of this world, the darkness of sin that separates us from God, the darkness of the demonic forces that work against our knowledge of God. And he said, I will show you the way home. The way home is to the Father. See, without Jesus, we would be lost in the dark, out in the water, floating aimlessly, afraid and alone. But he shows us the way out of the darkness, out of our brokenness. He shows us the way home. One day, Jesus was in the court of women where, during the Feast of Tabernacles, they lit these great candelabras in memory of God's presence with the people of Israel. Well, one day when Jesus was in that place, he said these very words, John 8:12, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Jesus was saying something radical to that Jewish listening audience. He was saying, you celebrate the presence of God that was with the nation of Israel in the wilderness by lighting these huge candelabra. Well, here I am. I'm him in the flesh. I am that same God. I am your Messiah. I am the light of the world. If you follow me, you won't walk in darkness ever again. I'll give you sight to see the truth. I'll lead you to the Father. Well, in the next chapter, he demonstrates that he is light. And he went out and he healed a blind man. John 9, verse 5 says, I am the light of the world. And after saying that, he spit on the ground, made some mud with the saliva, and put it on the man's eyes. Go, he told him, wash in the pool of Siloam. So the man went out and washed and came home seeing. You know, when we follow Jesus, who is the light, he frees us from darkness and he heals our spiritual blindness and he leads us home to the Father. You'd think that everyone would welcome the light of Christ, right? But scripture actually tells us that's not the case. John 3:19 says, this is the verdict. The light has come into the world, but men love the darkness rather than the light because their deeds were evil. See, Satan wants us to be blind to the light. He wants to keep us in the dark, and sin has a way of blinding us. Because of our shame, we choose to hide. We don't want to be exposed. But Jesus says, I'm the light and I will bring you to safety. I'll bring you to freedom. I'll remove your shame and I'll bring you to the Father. Just as that boat needed a little light on a hill to lead us safely home, we're told that to follow the light of Christ, Jesus' death and resurrection broke through the darkness, lighting the way for us. If you're feeling lost on the water of life, well, look to Jesus. He is the way home. And that's courageous living.